And hello, welcome to Art Talk, the place where we cultivate the art of agreeing or disagreeing, depending. My name is René Vöchtli. My guest today is Dr. Francis Vandrell, and our topic is coherence. Hello, Francis.
Hello, welcome.
I've really been looking forward to our talk because I've known you for such a long time, and you're one of the persons I really, really enjoyed agreeing to disagree with.
I like very much to debate and to share ideas as well.
Yes, and that has been the nature of our conversation. We haven't agreed on everything, but we've never disagreed to the point where it affected our personal relationship. And I think I have been learning a lot from you as far as cultivating this particular art is concerned. But today I don't want to talk to you about our relationship or how greatly we've already refined this particular art. I'd rather speak to you in your role as a scientist. Now, many people may not know you, so you're of course a Reiki master, a Reiki teacher. You're a father of a wonderful daughter. You're a wonderful husband, I presume. I haven't spoken to your wife. You're a teacher also of physics. You're a Zen Buddhist, and there is a whole mixed bag of things. Don't you sometimes find those many hats you're wearing contradictory to each other?
Well, no. Usually people ask me how I can at the same time be a physicist and a Reiki teacher, for example, because they... Some people see that that's contradictory. Actually, from my point of view, it's not. What we need actually is a transdisciplinary approaches, and that's very important to create knowledge which is unite and complete. That's quite important actually. The reality, the universe is not split into parts, into different parts. It's just unity. So we need to study the universe, to experience the universe in a united way as well.
Yeah, this is of course exactly the kind of conversations and topics and ideas which fascinate me too, and which I know we've been speaking about for a long time. And it's interesting, you used an interesting word, contradictions. I find when we talk about Reiki that very often we are very quickly in a whole lot of contradictions. A lot of people see Reiki as an energy in the sense, in the classical sense of something which oscillates between positive and negative, resistance, no resistance, from A to B. And at the same time, we, most of the Reiki people, feel that the Reiki has like an inherent intelligence, so to speak, that it works to the highest good, as many of us, including myself, like to say, which of course liberates us from the necessity to analyze, diagnose, because the concept then is that we are treating a human being, whether that be ourselves or another person, always holistically. So that's the kind of contradictions which have accompanied me over the years in the Reiki community. And you know, in preparation of our conversation today, I went through my library and I thought, do I find any literature which is dwelling on the question, how does this supposed energy, and I know you and I have started to differentiate even in the spelling between the teaching of Reiki, the philosophy of Reiki, the tradition of Reiki, the profession of Reiki with a capital R. And when we speak about the energetic phenomenon, we even spell it differently. We put it in italic and in lowercase R. So there's been very little literature, and to me, my comprehension of Reiki has greatly been influenced by my own teacher, and I quickly got his book out of my library, which was released in 97, I believe, and it says The Science, Metaphysics, and Philosophy of Reiki, and there's very little other literature within the Reiki community dwelling on the question, what is the source of this phenomenon? And I know you have been researching, and by your trade, of course, and by your background, academic background, and what you said in the introductory words, where you're looking at the universe, you've been deeply looking into this question. And I know you have fallen in love with the term coherence. And this is precisely why we've chosen the name of our topic today, coherence. Talk to me a little bit about coherence, please.
Okay. So coherence is a very deep has a very deep meaning, we say that life is based on coherence. Actually, if you look at, for example, a clock or a car, the coherence is not part of the functioning of a car or a watch, but coherence is part of the functioning of life, actually, and it's a very, very important subject in biophysics. The idea is actually that if coherence in the body is weakened in a way or in another, then we will feel not very well. Maybe we will fall ill and have all kind of illnesses. So if we can recover this coherence and enhance the coherence of the body and spirit, then probably we will again be healthy. So the idea within the Reiki method is actually to enhance the coherence of the body with our hands. That's the main point. Well, about contradiction, actually, there are a lot of contradiction maybe in our understanding of the universe, of nature, but these are obviously only related to our lack of understanding and of the laws behind universe. And the question if Reiki is an intelligent energy or not is actually a bit strange, because do we say that water is intelligent because water comes from, for example, the top of a mountain and goes into the sea by choosing a pathway? No, actually, no. The water is not intelligent in that way. Just follow the rule of the universe, actually.
Yeah, I won't enter the argument that, of course, water has very special properties, very unique to water, nor will I enter the argument that water has a special capacity of adapting to its environment, like you say, in more than just the obvious physical, following the obvious physical law of gravity, for example, and even that water has this capability of memory. I get your point. I would like to show you my way of how I understand that Reiki works. There was a, maybe first I show you something else. Maybe first I read to you what my teacher has written about his take, and then I show an experiment which is in relationship to what he's saying it. He is referring to Reiki as a non-polarized subatomic energy that is released as a harmonic into energy blueprints, such as our bodies, that are in a state of disharmony. Of course, there won't be such a discharge if the blueprint is in perfect harmony, meaning if it's healthy. Once it leaves the subatomic world, it must polarize because it is entering the physical manifest world where it is acted upon by time. Because it is, by nature, a harmonic, it will polarize and form a mirror image of any disharmonious frequency in that energy blueprint, thereby restoring normal harmony and well-being. This, in turn, accelerates the natural healing process of the body. Now, this mirror image is something very interesting. And when I listened to one of your public talks, I can't remember whether it was in Portugal or in the UK, in Scotland, it occurred to me that there is a coherence between what you say and what this teacher of mine has said and what this following experiment is showing. I'd like to include this. Can you see my beautiful drawing here?
Yes.
So in New Zealand in the late 80s, 90s, they apparently, it's a legendary experiment, made the following experiment. They took a plant and they attached it to a machine. This was a developed NASA board with, what do I know, electrodes being attached to the plant to get an energetic readout. So I, as a layperson, will see this drawing as a palm tree, but you, as a scientist, you will look at the energetic readout on a computer screen in waves and say these five black lines, they are the palm tree. They then went a step further and they did something rather drastic. They burnt the a leaf. And of course, as was to be expected, one of the lines changed. I changed it here to a red line. So the scientist will look at the graph, at the computer screen, and then say, oh, here with the red line, I can see this is an unhealthy blueprint, an unhealthy palm tree. Then they went a step ahead, and here comes the Reiki man with his magic in his hand, and he treated the roots. And lo and behold, they made an interesting discovery on the screen. For a brief second, this appeared. Now, this is the perfect mirror image of the red line. And technology nowadays, for a long time, they're using the mirroring of, for example, noise in a car or in a jet airplane. They're taking the noise, they're mirroring it, and then on your headphone you have what they call gray noise, which basically is silence. And so what we see here is that these two lines, they are actually like nullified. They balance each other out. When they finished this, when this disappeared again, that red line reappeared closer to the original black line. In other words, they could see healing taking place. So this is somewhat of how I understand Reiki to work, that it responds to the negativity, so to speak, to the disharmony in an energy system by basically reacting to it the way it needs to be reacted to, following a natural law, not by an intelligence in the sense of a higher it commands, but like gravity, responding, mirroring the disharmony. So, Francis, I was wondering, rather speaking to you personally again than looking at the whiteboard and my drawings, does that gel somewhat with what you think?
Well, that's very interesting what you said, actually, because when we're talking about disharmony, actually, we can translate it in a more scientific term by saying that disharmony is actually incoherence and harmony is coherence. So the question is how to change, modify incoherence toward coherence. That's a very important subject. And you give a very good example of how we can, for example, cancel noise using the negative of the wave. But there are other ways to do that. And actually, there is a subject which is not well understood in general by the public. Is the question of entropy. Entropy is disorder. And we know that actually the disorder in the universe is higher and higher every second, actually. This is the second law of thermodynamics. And the contradiction is that actually, if we consider living beings or animals or or plants, we are not disorder. We are made of order, actually. So the question is how nature is able to create ordered things as we are. And that's a very, very important question. And it is actually possible. It is actually possible. And there are other laws of physics which enables this. And now the question is how to maintain or to create more order within ourselves, which means more harmony, which means more coherence, right? And if we look at the way we practice, when we do hand application, we can observe that there is heat coming out from our hands or coming out of the body of the recipient, right? And usually we interpret this heat coming this heat as originating mm-hmm. from the energy we transmit somehow, but this interpretation is not correct, actually. We shouldn't actually think about energy. Reiki is not really an energy. The body gets its energy from the food. And only from the food, actually. So what we need is not to give energy. It's just we need just to maintain order or to enhance the order within our body. And actually, the heat is a very well disordered energy. Heat is totally disordered energy. It has a very high entropy. Sorry. So when heat is generated, actually it means that disorder is rejected from the body to create more order. Sorry. So that's another way to see it, and this way to look at this phenomena seems to me very, very more deep and has potential to explain a lot of phenomena related to the Reiki practice.
I quite agree with you. I, as a lay person, hear you talk and you speak about order, nature's thrive in the whole universe, which is aiming at creating a state of order in its process. This to me is very much synonymous almost to what I read out to be a harmonic. Order and harmony are very closely related, if not one and the same thing, even for our conversation at least. So this I find very fascinating. And to me, it also gives insight in how what people often think is Reiki when they're touching another human being, when they're practicing the laying on of hands, and they muster actual physical energy, which can be directed in comparison to the Reiki energy, the phenomenon we are talking about here, which is somewhat beyond our direct influence. It does what it wants as a natural cause in the striving for this state of order which you have described. Would you agree with my summary or with my take of what you said?
Well, yes. I mean, I should make a precision. When we talk about order, we talk about actually dynamic order. It's not static order. That's important to realize that. And strangely, in some circumstances, natures like to produce order. And nature produces order within a system by actually creating more disorder outside of the system, right? So if you want to create order within yourself, strangely, you have to create disorder outside of yourself, which is quite weird somehow. But if you don't do that,
it's all about it.
Yeah, if you don't do that, you will be in contradiction with the second law of thermodynamics.
I'll tell her.
So if you look at a tornado, which is a quite somehow destructive process, nevertheless, it is a creation of order, because all the winds which goes around the tornado are very well organized. There is some kind of cooperative behavior of the winds, which maintains the tornado for some times. So somehow we are living beings are like tornadoes actually, because we are out of equilibrium processes, and we have to maintain this order within ourselves by creating always more disorder outside of ourselves. And when we practice Reiki, when we apply our hands on a recipient, then we're like a tornado somehow. We help our recipient to create order within himself or herself, but we don't. There is no need to transfer any energy to do that. Actually, that's the important point. And there is no transfer of energy. However, there is a transfer of coherence, right? And the important point is that we won't lose ourselves as Reiki practitioner, this inner coherence, contrary to some other healing practitioner, because we have our way in ourselves to always create more coherence. That's right. Reiki is able to always create more order or coherence from disorder. So illness is transformed into well-being, actually, in that way. That's it, more or less.
And I'm glad you said that, because we're coming towards the end of our conversation. I'm sorry I misconnected a second ago. The viewers can also see where they can contact you. Of course, there will also be a description in the YouTube video here at the bottom. Now in the ticker, they have your website. You know that I personally am much involved in trying to participate or contribute, rather, in the Reiki community to create a state of order, so to speak, and I call it my reconciliation work, because I think the act of reconciling is also a giving, creating order. And when I looked up the word coherence in one of the the lexicons, it says the quality of state of cohering, such as systematic or logical connection or consistency, integration of diverse elements, relationships, or values. And I read this and I thought, well, this is also a definition of a reconciliation. So, Francis, we're coming to an end, and I'd like you to tell me a little bit, maybe, how you feel at this point in time, how you are, and how this conversation was for you.
Oh, it was interesting. There are so many things to tell about this this concept, and I like to add that there is a simple definition of coherence. You can say that coherence is both cohesion and synchronization. So this can be applied also to social fields, to relationships, and to groups, obviously.
Well, thank you very much. This was a very wonderful talk. I would like to continue this talk, maybe in a few months' time, if you have time. And obviously, the Reiki community's hope is great that you will contribute in the Reiki community to more and more scientific insights from your physical point of view or physicist's point of view. And I thank you for that, and I hope to see you again sometime.
I will happy to do that. Thank you very much, René.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.